They sort of ad-lib. The result? A fashion freefall that's silly and exhilarating.
Tonight, at the apparent suicide of popular jazz singer Phyllis Hyman. The 45-year-old Hyman was supposed to sing at the Apollo Theater tonight, but her assistant found her unconscious in her Midtown apartment this afternoon. She died at a nearby hospital. Police say pill bottles and notes were found near Hyman's body. Jazz singer Phyllis Hyman, dead of an apparent suicide at age 45.
Two of this country's biggest and most reputable newspapers are struggling.
Hit the music world today. R&B singer Phyllis Hyman was found dead in her apartment this afternoon. Hyman, who was 45, was scheduled to appear at the Apollo Theater tonight. She made a name for herself as a Motown great and a jazz singer. Police say she apparently committed suicide.
Shame. Still ahead, are you tired of your job? Our special report focuses on the 25...
Music world tonight, the legendary diva of modern pop, R&B, and jazz, Phyllis Hyman, is dead.
And although she is gone, she will never, ever be forgotten.
The announcement on stage at the Apollo stunned many in the crowd waiting outside.
Music world lost somebody very important.
Yeah.
Very important tonight. Yes. Oh, that's a shame.
She's a good singer.
Yeah. She's great.
She performed.
Great.
Oh, man.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah.
Police say she was found dead in her Manhattan apartment, an apparent suicide. Phyllis Hyman was 45. The entertainment world is also mourning the death of actress Lana Turner tonight. She was the glamorous blonde whose discovery at a soda fountain became a Hollywood legend. She appeared in such...
Good evening. Memorial services will be held tomorrow night in New York City for jazz diva Phyllis Hyman. She took her life Friday, just hours before she was scheduled to perform at the Apollo Theater. In a statement released today, her family thanked everyone for their love and support and said Phyllis's tragic death is a wake-up call for everyone in pain to know there is no need to be alone and to get help for your pain. In the small African country of Rwanda, the reality of inmates living in...
Here. A loving memorial tonight was held for a woman whose music touched so many. Songstress Phyllis Hyman died on Friday. Authorities say she committed suicide. Tonight, fans and friends packed St. Peter's Community Church in Manhattan. Family members remembered Hyman, who grew up in Pennsylvania, as somebody who was loved around the world. She was a master of pop, R&B, and jazz. Hyman won a Tony Award for her performance in the Broadway hit Sophisticated Ladies.
And let us hear with the sports.
Well, Sue.
And won an order of protection, and Marriott is currently being held in a New York County jail on a $20,000 bond. A court appearance is scheduled for later on this month. Sultry singer Sade is being sued. Her former drummer... The music industry is being mourned this week. Singer Phyllis Hyman took her own life last Friday. Her memorial service and funeral...
...was found dead in her Manhattan apartment. Police are calling it a suicide. Channel 2's Reggie Harris has the details.
I'm in the prime of my life, drawing thunder.
It seems Phyllis Hyman may have been in the prime of her life when this 1991 CD was released. Police say the 45-year-old jazz pop diva was found dead this afternoon at her apartment on West 56th Street with empty pill bottles and notes around her. Police are calling it an apparent suicide.
Unfortunately, we have to give you the sad news today that Phyllis Hyman has passed away.
Hyman was scheduled to play the Apollo Theater tonight. Fans were lining up when they got the news.
I was a great admirer of hers, and she's truly missed. She'll truly be missed.
It's really sad, you know. Nothing else to say.
The question everyone asks is why. For an hour last night, Phyllis Hyman spoke with longtime friend, Broadway actor Anthony Chisholm, who says she was depressed about her career. Younger divas have taken the spotlight, and the bookings just weren't coming as frequently.
And she said, you choose to stay here, and I don't. And then she hung up.
Chisholm says he called back, but that she would get hostile when he tried to return to that conversation. Chisholm and keyboardist Onaji Allen Gums, who arranged Hyman's first hit song, came to the Apollo tonight hoping to save her life. They found it was too late.
Here we had a very precious woman who was suffering, okay, because maybe she didn't think she was living up to the image that the business wanted.
It was Phyllis's signature song, I think.
The song is Friends. Phyllis Hyman, pictured here years ago with this reporter, had many friends and fans who will now miss her. She would have turned 46 next Thursday. In Harlem, Reggie Harris, Channel 2 News.